These days, viruses, antibodies, and vaccines are the buzzwords. Holding on to these key terms, I would like to discuss our recent research.
Today, I am going to discuss about two projects related to aquaculture. I am going to talk about viral theranostics and their importance in leveraging aquaculture. I am Jyotika Rajwade, a scientist working in the nanobioscience group of Agarkar Research Institute. Now, why is aquaculture important? Aquaculture is often referred to as the Blue Revolution. It is the cultivation of seafood as a source of dietary protein and nutraceuticals. The Indian aquaculture industry is expanding due to increasing domestic and foreign demand. More importantly, aquaculture supports the livelihoods of millions of farmers. But all is not good. Bacterial, fungal, and viral diseases are a threat to successful aquaculture. This is because of high-density farming practices, the import and export of seafood, and as you all know, all the land masses are connected by water. The fallout of diseases is huge economic losses. For example, the white spot syndrome virus continues to be a major threat to the Indian aquaculture even today. There are other important pathogens such as Macrobrachium Rosenbergi nodavirus, infectious myonecrosis virus, and hepatopancreatic parvovirus. To detect these infections, there are various molecular techniques such as PCR, RT-PCR, but currently no field usable molecular diagnostic is available. Farmers do not require a quantitative result. Another point is that the farmer can have a yes or no result, and hence we decided to develop a gold nanoparticles based lateral flow test to detect the presence of WSSV. The lateral flow assay is a proven technology with applications in agriculture, forensic science, environment, medical diagnostics, and so on. We went on to develop a lateral flow assay for the detection of WSSV by employing polyclonal antibodies against the VP28 protein of the WSSV. We standardized the lateral flow assay, and during this work, we realized that there were several hurdles in obtaining antibodies. And hence, we decided to use another technology, peptide phage display library, to obtain peptides that can work as an alternative to antibodies for the detection of WSSV. A patent based on the peptide probe that was isolated is already submitted. These peptides as biorecognition elements were robust in nature. There was no need to immunize animals and obtain anti-sera for diagnostic applications. Another aspect was that the requirement for cold storage was completely eliminated. Very recently, we developed another rapid field-usable diagnostic for the detection of Macrobrachium Rosenbergi in the post-larval stages. The diagnostics developed were validated in surveillance program where samples were collected from all coastal states in India and tested using our kit, and the results were compared with the gold standard PCR. Thus, we found that the diagnostic saves time and cost. The results are rapid, easy to interpret. The test could be carried out at any stage. Thus, laboratory dependency is reduced. Currently, we are exploring the possibilities for multiplex detection also. Since we already had a peptide with us, in several forums, during discussions, we realized that there is a possibility of using the peptide as a therapeutic. A peptide could be a vaccine candidate to achieve prophylaxis by evoking both cellular and humoral immunity. The current requirements in the aquaculture sector are farmer-friendly vaccines and easy-to-use methods for vaccine delivery. Currently, injection, immersion, and oral delivery are the three modes for vaccine administration. However, out of these methods, we are focusing on developing effective nanoformulations for oral delivery of peptides and other biomolecules. To begin with, we used bioinformatics tools to understand the interactions of the small peptides with the surface proteins. This work will help in designing appropriate peptides as vaccines. Lastly, I would like to acknowledge all those who have helped us in this work. The financial support for the work was from Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. Thank you.